Sir, I rise to support the objectives of this bill completely and wholeheartedly. Sir, like many other bills that we pass in Parliament, it is yet another bill that is no doubt driven by good intentions and will clearly entail significant spending. But I think it raises more questions than it provides answers to critical issues like education outcomes, financial sharing, delivery of education, etc., sir. So we all accept that this is the single biggest investment we can make for the future of our nation. But there is a need to go beyond the rhetoric and vision into what will make or unmake the goals that we are setting for ourselves and the promises that we are making to our children in this bill. So therefore, I'll make a few brief points to add to what my honourable colleagues have already said in Parliament, sir. Sir, we all accept that despite the work of the Kothari Commission, which was appointed in 1964, with broadly the same set of goals, the country has achieved very little of the goals and objectives set out by the Indian Education Commission in the 60s. Understanding the why of this will be very important if we are to make this bill a success on the ground. I look forward to hearing from the Honourable Minister his views on what went wrong in the last 60 years. Sir, one of the big mistakes we are making is to assume that education is simply about building more schools or bringing private sector into elementary education. That would be, in my humble opinion, naive. The education problem in our country is more about capacity building through the entire education value chain, which includes at the core of it teachers and faculty as much as school infrastructure, the software and the hardware of education. This bill seems to focus predominantly on the hardware of education, i.e. schools. The biggest crisis facing education in India, in my opinion, sir, is that the profession of teaching is on the decline, both in terms of numbers and in terms of the quality. I would urge the government to focus on this issue in more than a passing way, as it has in the bill so far. What is the total number of teachers required? What kind of capacity for training and developing teachers of tomorrow is the government envisaging through this bill? What is the government going to do to make teaching an attractive profession for the upcoming students? I would like to hear from the minister more on his strategy around these issues. Second, sir, is the issue of the government school system itself. Somehow I get the sense that the government and the minister's strategy is to use private schools to increase competition and quality in government schools. Sir, with the greatest respect to this dream, this is not going to happen as some automatic consequence of private school and investor entry into elementary education. The government school system needs top-to-bottom reform and restructuring, starting with faculty compensation, infrastructure equipment, facilities improvement, and creating a cadre of teachers and principals that can do their job with sufficient oversight but with little political interference. Unless the existing government school system is invested in, reformed and modernized, they will suffer the fate that they are already suffering, which is that students will move to private schools for better quality education. Without fixing the current government school system, widespread entry of private school will hasten the demise of government schools. If you don't believe this theory, please look around you in other areas like hospitals, airlines and telecom, where private sector competition without preparing the government entity do not result in any improved quality or competitiveness on the part of the public entity. Rather, it hastens its decline into irrelevance. Sir, finally, there are many more ambiguities around in the bill around the role of the local government, state and the central government in discharging the central obligation of providing universal education, which needs clarity and addressing. As we all know, sir, many bills have been passed by this House that have just resulted in increased litigation due to the broad interpretive and administrative discretion and grey areas in the legislation draft itself. So, sir, in ending, I request the Minister to address these issues to make this dream of universal education a reality. Otherwise, it will remain an empty promise and make this bill yet another case of when in doubt, legislate. Thank you, sir.